The Shin-Etsu Trail is a 110-km-long trail that runs along the border between Nagano and Niigata prefectures. The trail was developed in the Sekita mountain range area and the Naba foothills area. It connects a number of Setoyama where wonderful nature and people's lives coexist. Hiking is a vertically oriented adventure that aims for mountain peaks. In contrast, long trails are horizontal. It allows you to experience not only nature, but also culture, history, and contact with the people who live there. And the longer the distance, the stronger and deeper the experience. The trail is divided into 10 sections. Of these, the section that captured my heart was section 9. In this section, you can walk through the unexplored village of Akiyama-go. The route crosses a suspension bridge and follows an ancient path walked by Edo period writer Suzuki Bokushi. The 9.7-kilometer walk takes 5 to 6 hours and is a fascinating section where visitors can experience the symbiosis between nature and man. Departs from Katakuri Inn. It is an accommodation facility converted from an abandoned school. It is a visitor center for the Shin-Etsu Trail, and camping is possible on site. For a long time, Akiyama-go has been completely isolated from the outside world in winter due to the depth of its snow. This isolation provided the soil for a unique culture, which is still strongly preserved today. In 1892, 13 settlements, including here at Kedo Settlement, were designated exempt from compulsory education because of their very remote location. From then on, they could not benefit from education until it was lifted in 1936. How much despair was spreading there? 43 years have passed, deprived of any hope of education. Was there ever such a place in Japan? There is still much we need to know. Those who continued to seek education in this village built a private primary school and taught reading, writing, and abacuses, continuing the Terakoya style of education. Local experts were appointed as teachers, and the village supported all costs and supplies necessary for education and the teachers' livelihoods. It was an unimaginable burden. However, they desperately protected the children's future. Nevertheless, the lack of a diploma sometimes put them at a disadvantage in further education and employment. Today, the place has ceased to serve as a school, but it continues to exist as a place where people gather, carefully and wholeheartedly protected. Thank you. How gentle the rain is. This rain brings nostalgic moments quietly and softly, as if telling a story. Is that the entrance to the Mikura Tunnel? Wrong path. The trail should wind around this tunnel. There used to be a settlement here called Amazak Village. Its quiet life was exposed to a major crisis, the Tempo Famine. The famine, which began in 1833, deprived the inhabitants of Amazak Village of their harvest. There would certainly have been people there who had lived a humble and beautiful life. During the famine, the inhabitants of Amazak Village died of starvation, and the village was abandoned. Amazak Village's name was erased from the map. Today, only a stone monument and some stone structures remain, quietly tell that a village once existed here. The remnants of the forgotten village blend into the silence of the windswept Kusatsu Highway and will be buried in the passage of time. I got out to the Naba Shrine. Was the site of the Amazak Village a little further up that road? Thank you. In Ikiamago, the culture of group bear hunting by hunters known as Matagi has taken root since the Edo period. Today, there are only a few Matagi in Ikiamago, but they live their lives while preserving their traditions, including their rituals and manners. I ate bear meat for the first time. I thought bear meat was tough and smelly. But in fact, it was tender, with fat between the fibers and a glutinous texture. And it was slightly sweet. Bear was delicious. The life of the bear melted on my tongue as warmth. Its sweetness and weight enveloped me. Then night falls and silence envelops the village. What do you think of on a night like this? Have a hearty breakfast. Everyday eating is not just an act of survival, it touches our hearts and has deep roots in our culture. It is a place to share time with family and friends. It is also a moment to savor the bounty of nature in each season. By eating, we connect with nature, inherit the wisdom and traditions of the land. It's been a wonderful 2 days. I was really happy to be here.